Hi, my name is Shamik, and I am the CEO and founder of TrustRace. We are a fashion supply chain traceability and transparency platform. It's the first time for us to be in apparel sourcing, and we also have got a booth at Hall 2D 135 in case you guys want to see the full demo of the platform. So TrustRace is a company which is headquartered in Sweden, in Stockholm, and then we have a large operations in India. We have got around 25 brands who are using our platform across Europe, and then we have got around 3,000 suppliers who are on our platform to provide us information regarding the processes, the material integrity that they do. I'm here today to talk about traceability and how you are able to achieve better traceability and transparency. They're about leading to better sustainable products using digital technologies, which makes it faster, cheaper, and better for you to collect this kind of information. Before I get started on that, let me also share with you how we got started about TrustRace. So the four founders of TrustRace, we come from India. And from a region where I think the water has got significantly polluted from the effluents coming from textile industry one, and also other industries like pharma industry and all. So the rivers or the ponds and lakes where we used to typically play when we were growing up, now they are polluted and no human being can go and take a bath there also, right? So this was the story that got us started, that I think we need to take an action towards an industry by which we are able to change the industry to a much more cleaner, better, and more sustainable supply chain. So what we are doing here is that we are helping brands to tell the full story of the product. When I say full story of the product, it is means that they also are bringing about sustainable information and sustainability information as well as quality information regarding the product. If you look at it, most of the brands have been selling their products based on style, material, design part of it. But I think new age consumers, specifically the Generation Z, as well as us also, maybe nowadays when we walk into a mall or a shop, we typically ask the brands that, can you please tell me how it has been produced, who has made it, and where it is produced, right? Earlier, we used to see this tag called made in China, made in Vietnam, made in India. But I think it has lesser meaning nowadays, because we all know that when you talk about a product nowadays, a product can touch almost five continents, so many different countries. You can have a wool coming from New Zealand. It is getting processed in Taiwan. It mixes the yarn getting made in India, and then fabric being done in Italy, and then stitching done somewhere, right? So it has got a long journey. So I think the brands, some of these brands have started sharing this information. For example, if you take a few brands like Ascot or maybe Cezanne from France, these kind of brands are much ahead. They have started collecting a lot of this information regarding the full supply chain and presenting it to their customers, retailers, and all that. Now, once they start, they want to do this kind of a traceability journey. I think the biggest challenge they face is a typical supply chain touches something like 15 to 20 different facilities, and also it touches almost like 100 different bill of material items. Now, when you want to collect data of this quantity only for one style, you can understand manually to do this is a humongous task. So typically, most of the bigger brands are able to put in a lot of people behind it. For example, they can put maybe 50 or 100 odd production controllers to collect this information from various parts of the world. But smaller brands, and also many of the bigger brands, when they want to cover it for all of their products, they find it impossible to collect this volume of data. Challenges are typically that the data that is coming from the supply chain, is it the correct data or not? Suppliers are also not very sure what the brand is asking, so they feed in different or maybe incorrect data. Sometimes the suppliers, they are not able to understand why a brand is asking these questions. So there are multiple such problems that they face. So data collection is the biggest challenge or issue that a brand or the supplier face in collecting and sharing of data. The second, I think the biggest problem is the data that is coming in, is it the right data or not? Sometimes a supplier may commit an error. Sometimes the brand would have may have asked a wrong question to the supplier, and then you know that it is garbage in, garbage out kind of an information. Many a times suppliers also try to put in information, and they are very, very cautious about putting what kind of information, because it may have a huge impact for them on the way their profile is seen by the brand. So we as a when we are trying to do this verification of this data, then the third part is presentation of data to do multiple analysis. Brands nowadays want to analyze the data for typically what is their material exposure. Are they having sufficient amount of organic materials like organic cotton or responsible wool in their materials? Do they have sufficient amount of exposure to the right kind of social and labor compliance aspects of it? So it is very important for them to visualize this so that they can take the right action. So data collection, verification and validation of the data, and then the analysis of the data, currently which is being done manually, is lot of it is error prone. The quality of data suffers significantly because as human beings, we are not prepared to do repetitive, boring tasks. So that is where I think a digital platform comes and helps such kind of setups. So at TrustRace, what we have done is that we have created around 6 different modules for covering these issues. So we have got a module called T-Trace to trace the complete journey of the product right from the source to the end product. We have a module called T-Evidence Management, which is effectively to collect all the evidences regarding material integrity, right from organic cotton, responsible wool, leather, various kind of these materials. Third is that we have got a T-Supplier Management, effectively to run and collect assessment information from the supply chain. And this covers aspects of environmental, social, and ethical standards. You're also able to upload various audits that are done by various companies, like a BSCI audit, like a Fairware Foundation audit. And you have all of this information sitting in the supplier profile. So what it happens is that now once you have collected the data using these 3 modules, you can do actions like you can calculate the carbon footprint of a particular product using our climate action module. You can also communicate the story of the product to your end customer using what we call a customer engagement tool. Zalando and many such retailers are also promoting sustainable products. A brand is able to go and claim that my product is sustainable by collecting various information which the Zalando wants, and then get a sustainable tag to it. It's very interesting that brand or retailers like Zalando or Galeries Lafayette are typically promoting sustainable products because they are seeing that significant amount of sales movement once a product is called sustainable. So we are able to help the brands to increase the or accelerate the whole process of collecting these kind of evidences. Then once you have, so these are the 6 modules that we have. The other interesting part of our platform is that we have a team of around 15 people who are constantly working with the suppliers, educating them and also helping them to use the platform by filling in maximum amount of data. This helps the brands and the suppliers to collect and process the right amount of data. So this team is what we call our business services team. And they are currently based in India, but they travel to different parts of the world to train the suppliers to use the platform so that everybody sees the right data in there. We also use in our platform things like chat bots, by which people, suppliers and brands can interact and then can fill in this information into the platform. All of this leads to a typical reduction of around 80 to 90% in terms of effort. The quality of data goes up at least by 200 to 300%. And then finally, they are able to create business cases by which for better sales and better margin improvement there. To do all of this, we are using in the platform, we use artificial intelligence as well as blockchain as the underlying technologies to do this whole process. We are also using cloud technologies predominantly to ensure we are able to collect data from web, from the mobile, as well as from tablets across the globe, right? Having done all of this, what we have seen is that the critical success factor for most of the traceability, transparency, and sustainable goals is that you need to ensure that right people from the brands, right people from the suppliers, and right people from also audit agencies and standards are involved in this whole process to collect this data. We have, as of now, collected or done full traceability and transparency for around 25,000 different products, right from shoes, jackets, jeans, various kind of products. And the essence comes down to how better you are able to train the people, how better you are able to motivate them, and finally, you give very simple means for them to collect the data. I will give you one example that when we started working with a few of the suppliers in China, I think they were typically at the yarn level, and they did not have access to facilities like scanners and all. So we actually integrated our platform with a WeChat platform, by which we are able to collect data through WeChat. So like very simply, they're able to point their smartphone, take a picture of the certificate or the questions that we are asking, and then they are able to send it to our platform and then we process it. So such kind of integrations go a very, very long way in making the platform accessible and easy for them to share the data like this. There are many such examples that I can quote of people using it. Like in our platform, we support around 21 different languages. So you can be a supplier in Italy who is replying in Italian, and the platform will translate it into English or French, and you can read all the responses in French or English. This is a better way by which everybody are able to communicate freely in their language of their preferences. And this is what helps in good quality of data and presentation of data. Finally, I think I would like to say that traceability, transparency, and sustainability used to be a good to have case. I think the world has moved towards a point where these are must have. And I think we are seeing a significant amount of interest coming on from consumers as well as government agencies who want to make this change faster. So if you use a platform like TrustTrace, you are able to do this, as I mentioned to you, cheaper, better, faster, and more importantly, with very good quality of data. So I'm around here. If you guys want to discuss or present any of your cases, I am more than happy to take any questions or any views. Thank you. So the question I think is the question is how do we verify and validate the data that comes in from the manufacturers? So in the platform, first of all, when a supplier joins the platform, he's requested to fulfill all the criteria regarding a profile. This will typically consist of your basic information regarding number of employees, gender, how many male, how many female, what kind of certifications you have, and then you upload all these evidences into the platform. In the platform, we use an artificial intelligence engine by which all this data is actually read. So if you upload a PDF file or a JPEG file, it will typically read and analyze the data and then will go and check, do a very basic check with the respective databases. Like if it is a ISO certification, we'll go and check it at the ISO level and all that. So this is basic profile creation. Then typically when you are dealing with any materials which is organic or recycled polyester, you have got transaction certificates which goes on to different bodies like GOTS and all, and you will get those transaction certificates. Typically all these transaction certificates are currently checked by brands and or tier one suppliers manually. And nobody checks the 100% of it. They check maybe open 4 or 5 certificates and then approve it. But in our platform, because it is software driven, we are able to check all these transaction certificate, correlate them across the full supply chain, because we know the supply chain that it is coming from. And then we are able to do again a basic second level verification. For anything to do with environmental, social or ethical, typically the brands or the tier one supplier will typically say that I want my supply chain to comply to a BSCI audit or to a Fairware Foundation or to a Blue Sign kind of certification. So they will do these audits once in a while, but we collect data related to these audits on a very frequent basis. For example, BSCI, right? Living wages. So we will ask them, can you please upload your wage bill for this month? And then we will analyze it, right? We are not saying it's a foolproof platform, but I think we are able to take out many of the issues that come with this whole environment, and we are at least 95% correct. If a supplier is gaming you and not giving you the right data, I think the trust gets broken, and then you should not have that supplier, right? We can easily do various other things, like we can do physical tagging, DNA tagging and all, but they tend to become very, very costly technologies for the fashion industry. They are well suited for high value products like jewelry or diamond, but not for the fashion industry. That's why we are doing all of these traceability using information traceability, and we are that, like we say that 95 to 96% is right. And you have to keep your eyes and ears open for the 4% of issues that can come in. So overall, we are able to, I think, verify significantly. We are, of course, improving our platform more and more to bring in new technologies to improve the verification and validation part of it. So I'll repeat the question again for everybody's sake. So your question is that the brand may be working with multiple different vendors. Who uploads this information into the platform, and does brand do it? So the way it works for us, we are here to simplify this whole objective of traceability. Typically, a brand will have the list of their key suppliers. So, and this is typically sitting in an Excel sheet or a ERP, because they are issuing purchase orders to these vendors. So we typically do an import from the ERP into our platform and get all of these tier one suppliers there. Sometimes the brand also knows the fabric suppliers, because they recommend a fabric supplier to a tier one supplier to make it, right? So we then also collect that information. We create something called a complete supplier master data list in our platform there. Then whenever you issue a purchase order or the brand issues a purchase order to the tier one supplier, we initiate something called a traceability request to them. So a tier one supplier will typically introduce us to the tier two suppliers. Tier two will introduce it to tier three, tier three to tier four, tier four to tier five. There. Tier 5 is typically where the raw material is coming from, right? Some, most of the brands we are working with, they typically want traceability till tier 3 now. Tier 4, tier 5, they want to do it in next 2 years or 3 years. So that is how we are able to, so to answer your question, so tier 1, the brand introduces, and introduces in the means we pick up the database and then using a brand support, we will send an email to them and then they will introduce us, then we will get in touch with the tier ones and start discovering the tier two, tier three, tier four. Exactly. So, and the reason I think, and one of the key success factors of us has been that we have got supplier incentive programs to join the platform. It's a very simple case I will give you. One of our suppliers was talking to a very large brand, and every year they come to the supplier and say that you have to give me a 3-5% discount, a common problem. So supplier, we help the supplier to collect all the evidences that regarding social, ethical, animal, and every aspects of it, and said and told the Mr. Brand, these are all the certificates or the requests that you have. You are only looking at the price point of labor, but these certificates to maintain, I have to have the facilities at a certain level. So this is my true cost of production. I cannot give you any further discount, but what I can enable you by giving the certifications, you can actually go into the market and will be able to claim a premium tag or a sustainable tag. So the discussions have turned out, has started moving more toward an evidence-based discussions than only being a price point-based discussions. But again, it is just few cases, and I think a lot of things need to change, but it is moving slowly there.